Okay. Was there anyone else who wished to make a comment today? Okay, anything further from the agency? And the agency, obviously, during the comment period, is likely to provide its own comments, so at the 20-day mark and, again, in the 5-day reply period. So let me just, again, emphasize that those written comment deadlines. Oh, did you have a question?
Yeah, I guess I'd like to say something in general. You know, if what we're doing, if this ends up having to close ice rinks, it's going to be a sad day.
Yes.
And I would anticipate, even with the current changes that they're proposing, that we're going to have some difficult situations out there. Going further, we could see maybe a third possibly closing or having financial difficulty that they'll be passed on to the user groups. It'll reject the bail. So again, my point earlier was, whatever happens with this, there's going to have to be some type of need for funding. And it's either going to be through taxpayers or through legislative bodies. Maybe it's through OSHA, maybe whatever, you know, health, work, and safety programs, grants, aids, whatever it is. Funding is going to be, to me, is a key for all of this. And or some types of solutions, for the issues that like, things have. Because kids are going to be without rain. They're going to be driving from, let's say, Moose Lake to Cloquet to get ice instead of being able to skate Moose Lake. Because maybe the Moose Lake won't be able to meet the requirements. And so now we put them on a highway, we drive them through the winter, and you think we have a risk of exposure for carbon monoxide, a risk for a traffic accident with 100 kids driving back and forth 60, 70 miles a day is unexcusable if these changes result in that. I understand everybody's concern, but somehow if we have major changes, we're going to see kids not being able to participate unless there's funding from the legislative bodies.
But does participation exclude the ability to asphyxiate yourself?
And I'll just note for the record, that's Mr. Blum. I'm sorry, this is where it's hard. If you have much to say, it would be helpful if you'd come close to a microphone, and we need to identify who's speaking. So just want to, I don't want to foreclose the discussion, but Ms. Davis?
Yes, Ms. Davis. I'd like to answer. I totally understand, and I can sympathize with Arena, but I spoke to how many people, many hockey parents and figure skating parents that would be willing to do fundraising for the $5,000. That is not a lot of money for a fundraiser to come up with, and they would be very happy to do so. You put your hockey association on board, and let me tell you, that $5,000 will come to you. So it is not impossible. Rings do not have to close. And what I'd like to say also is, just comparing it to some regulations that the health department has for restaurants. Should a restaurant that is unsafe be open to the public?
Sure.
So I think at what point do we have to put the public's health in front versus money? And this is where I really have a big issue.
Further comments, questions?
Well, and again, I'd just like to say I agree with what you're saying, but again, it comes down to funding. If we were talking about a school building, somebody comes out of the taxpayer's budget. Come and talk about an ice rink, it comes out of the user's budget, the user pocket. And that's one of the major issues. You know, a school district could not have these issues because the tax they would levy for a tax referendum, and or if they don't get it, but they would still, whether it's a health issue or not, the state of Minnesota would find a way to improve the health of that school. And I don't think that the ice rink is getting the same respect.
Okay. Further remarks?